It's me. I'm the one and only pastor's ex-wife. Ladies, have you ever thought that your innermost desire would never happen, and then it happened? Have you ever felt like a piece of the puzzle that just doesn't fit? Have you ever felt like just a legal pussy? I just want to say that, you know, I appreciate all of my fans for following my crazy journey, but I'm fascinated by my journey, and all of it does, I guess, happen for a reason. I used to say, I hate when people say shit happened for a reason, but guess it is true. If I hadn't gone through the bullshit, I wouldn't lie, whatever. But have you ever just, while you're going through your journey of life, knew you were just going, and you were just doing, but you didn't even belong in that situation, but you stayed in it? The fear of the unknown is a lot of reasons why women stay in situations that they know it's not for them. And I remember I said in my last relationship all the time, the whole 9 years, maybe the whole 8 years, first year was great, but then, and I used to always say, there's a piece of the puzzle that don't fit, you know, fuck that, you know, a piece of the puzzle that don't fit, but yet, kind of remind me of the Tina Turner movie, Ike and Tina Turner movie, when she said, Ike was spitting that shit to her, and then she's like, oh no, he was telling her about what he had gone through, and she said, oh no, I'll never do you. Like them other girls, I never do you like them. You know, that's the way women are. You know, women are ride or dies. You know, they just put up with shit. They do. They put up with shit. All for the sake of some label that don't mean shit, like ride or die. You know, all that old bullshit. But ladies, don't ignore, you know, what you know to be true. Don't ignore it. You know, I'm not the only one. A lot of you ladies are. You know, you know things, you feel things, and you just ignore it for whatever reason. And I believe it's because of the fear of the unknown. But when I tell you, I told my mom the other day, you know, nothing happened to me tomorrow. Trust, I lived my best days in my latter days. And of course, you know, my quit said, you know, they don't want to hear me say that, but you get to the point where you have peace. It is so crazy. But yeah. As little girls, you know, we have this dream of meeting the right person, and just being happy. And for a lot of females, that day never comes because we settle for, we just settle just because we want to be able to say, I got a man. I want to leave a legacy, and one of the legacies that I want to leave is that don't ignore the warning signs, if you would, if you want to call them warning signs. Don't ignore your heart. Everybody wanna try to box me in, suffocating every time it locks me in, painting their own pictures. Listen to your heart. I didn't. I kept over and over ignoring things because in my mind I felt like, you know, with all of this that I give, then it has to be all right. Not so. Not so. If you're in a fake situation, it's not real, you know. But when you get out of that situation, like the Fantasia song, sometimes you gotta lose to win again. When you get out of that situation and you meet real, God, I mean, it's amazing. Like the Beyonce song, Irreplaceable, to the left, you know, you find all your shit in the box by the door to the left, you know. I'll find another you in a minute. Matter of fact, you'll be here in a minute. And, but women don't, we don't give that a chance because we stay stuck. And I'm just tripping by the chain of events in my life because I said it before in, you know, in times past that I feel like a little girl in a candy store, or I feel like a kid at Christmas. But even though I was saying those things, I knew that behind closed doors, it just wasn't. It wasn't. And but now, the shit that I utter, it is. And I am that piece of the puzzle that fit. And I do feel like a freshman in college. And, you know, I keep saying it in my videos that I haven't cried in 5 years. And, but I'm smiling so much. And when I tell you, I am tripping. Now, the old adage is that if a man loves his mom, really, really loves his mom, not just saying I love your mom, but really, really loves his mom and takes care of his mom, that then that's the way he would be to his lady. And, but when a man can be cold toward his mother, or say things like, she gave me what she was supposed to give me. Now that I'm grown, I don't owe her anything because now I'm the grown person. Then you have a man that sees to it that his mother is taken care of. Not only that, but sees to it that she is smiling. Yeah. When I was with Lamont, he said, come see me, you know, come go with me. What are you doing on, you know, and gave me the date, and he said, come go with me. And I never had anybody. I'll take care of everything. I'll take care of all the expenses. I'm not used to that, you know. And I didn't answer right away. Maybe a week or 2 weeks, I said, I wonder if he was serious, because I had an epiphany, you know, sudden realization. And let me continue this on the next video.